So hello student, so today I will be discussing what are ionic solids, what are the constituents of ionic solids, what are the forces which holds ionic solid, that means the ions, what are the different example, what is radius ratio, what is coordination number. So let's see. So ionic solids, ionic solid is actually a type of crystalline solid. So it is three dimensional crystalline solid. Three-dimensional crystalline solid. The constituent here, constituent particles are ions. So ions are basically two types, anion which have negative charge and cation which have positive charge. This cation and anion held together by Coulombic force of attraction. So this cation and anion are held together by here we have Coulombic force of attraction. Coulombic force of attraction, also called electrostatic force of attraction. You must have read what is Coulomb's law. So Coulomb's law is F equal to K Q1 Q2 by R square, where the value of K is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So if you write, so F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. This is Coulomb's law. So the cations and anions are attracted by Coulomb's law. Let's see few examples. So the first example is NaCl. This is sodium chloride. This is sodium chloride. It is also the common table salt. So it is sodium chloride. Now, the correct formula of sodium chloride is Na plus Cl minus whole N. It is a three-dimensional ionic solid. One of the sodium ion is surrounded by six chloride ion and one of the chloride ion is surrounded by six sodium ion. So, the coordination number of sodium chloride is 6:6. The coordination number of sodium chloride is 6:6. So what is coordination number? Coordination number is the number of nearest neighbor of a particle. Suppose if we have a cation and it is surrounded by four anion, that means its coordination number is 4. If we have a cation which is surrounded by 6 anion, then the coordination number is 6. So range of coordination number. Range of coordination number. So coordination number ranges from 2 to 12. So coordination number is the number of nearest neighbor of a particle. The range of coordination number is 2 to 12. The range of coordination number is 2 to 12. If a cation is surrounded by 4 anion, then here we see that the coordination number is 4. If cation is surrounded by 6 anion, then the coordination number of 6. We can write in a reverse manner also. If anion is surrounded by, suppose, 6 cation, then the coordination number will be 6. Let's see few more examples of So if you can remember this, this will be helpful for your entrance exam. Ionic solids, coordination number, ZnS 4:4, NaCl 6:6, NaCl also called rock salt structure, KCl 6:6, cesium chloride 8:8, calcium chloride it is 8:4, Na2O sodium oxide it is 4:8. Calcium chloride is also called the fluoride structure, whereas sodium oxide is also called anti-fluoride structure. So keep it in mind. Cesium chloride has 8:8 coordination number. So let's see R plus by R minus. The radius of cation, the ratio of radius of cation to that of radius of anion, it is called radius ratio. Higher the radius ratio, higher will be the coordination number. So the ratio of radius of cation to that of radius of anion is called radius ratio. Higher the radius ratio, more will be the coordination number. So we can see here Na plus Cl minus. If we see the radius of this, so here what we have to do? We have to see the radius of Na plus by radius of Cl minus. If we see cesium chloride, so radius of cesium plus by radius of chloride ion. Since chloride is common for both these, so sodium is a smaller cation than cesium. Therefore, the radius ratio of sodium chloride is lesser than that of, so radius of cation to radius of anion of sodium chloride is less than radius of cation by radius of anion for cesium chloride. Therefore, the coordination number for NaCl is lesser than that of cesium chloride. So radius ratio gives idea about the coordination number. So let's see radius ratio, shape of crystal, coordination number and few examples of that particular coordination number. So up to 0.15, if the limiting radius ratio is up to 0.15, The shape of the crystal is linear. Coordination number in case of linear is 2. There is very few solids that is known. So, not at all. Not a single has been found with coordination number 2 in ionic. 0.15 to 0.225. If this is the range of the radius ratio, then the shape of the crystal is trigonal planar. This is also a rare type in ionic compound. The coordination number is 3. One such example is B2O3. That is called boric oxide, boric anhydride. Okay. 0.225. If the limiting radius ratio ranges from 0.225 to 0.414, then the shape of the crystal is tetrahedral. Coordination number is 4. Zinc sulfide, barium sulfide, copper chloride, copper iodide. These are the crystals which are the examples in case of tetrahedral with coordination number 4. From 0.414 to 0.732, there are two cases. One is the square planar with coordination number 4. Example is tetracyanonyclate 2. Tetracyanonyclate 2, it is a coordination compound. So the radius ratio, limiting radius ratio ranges from 0.414 to 0.732. So it is a square planar complex with coordination number 4. 0.414 to 0.732 octahedral, shape of the crystal is octahedral with coordination number 6. Example is NaCl MgO. NaCl sodium chloride, MgO is magnesium oxide. If greater than 0.732, the shape of the crystal is cubic. Coordination number is 8. Cesium chloride, ammonium bromide, cesium iodide, these are the crystals that have this type of structure. So if you can remember this table, you will be able to solve questions based on coordination number, examples, shape of the crystal, and their limiting radius ratio. Thank you, students. I will be discussing next topic, that is metallic solid, in my next video. Thank you so much.